security helmet set.
Right, they're right.
Stand him up.
Yeah, he's cautious. He's not cautious, so we can't really move him.
Go ahead and set him up. He's usually pretty proper.
You guys need?
Okay.
that damn. I'll be okay, bro. I'm struggling.
Slow down.
Exhale, so he's not letting more air in, or he's not bleeding
like that. Put it on.
Slap it on there. After that, obviously, if you don't have no chest seals, you're going to put something plastic bag, MRE, tape all four sides, write the time, if that.
Okay.
And, once you do that, what you're going to do is fucking blood rakes. See if anything else catches from here.
Yeah, nothing on the front.
You're going to flip him. First, you're going to check his pelvic. See if, fit bands or any of that weird stuff happens.
It's good.
It's good. I'm gonna flip him over. I'm gonna start blood raking from the back. If I find anything catching my finger, obviously I'm gonna put another chest seal.
Nope.
We're gonna start prepping our litter. Put our blanket. Assess him.
Good.
Make sure he's breathing properly.
Unequal left side.
Unequal left side?
Yep.
Unequal okay, case. NCD.
I'm just walking through it. I'm not going to put it in the dummy.
Is that left side?
Yep.
Yeah, left side.
I will put it.
The primary way?
It'll be between the third and fourth rib. We put it in there. Once we poke it and hear that hissing sound, then we engage the.
Catheter.
And then if that doesn't work, we go to our second position. We'll be aligned with the nipple and
at a 90 degree angle. Stick it in them.
In. Same process. Hearing the hissing sound. And putting
what
the.
Do you do? So what if that chest seal on the side? That's your primary site. So if it's covering your primary site, are you gonna go through it?
No. Yes. No. You go to your secondary site.
Secondary site. Alright, needle D's in, it's equal again, it's normal.
Alright,
circulation. Check his foot, he's good. Carotid.
Yep, he's got pulses.
Got pulse right here.
Yep.
Alright, then we're gonna move to hypothermia and head trauma.
Just
covering him right now, too. Head seems to be good.
I'll cover his front of the face.
Yeah, no symptoms of a traumatic brain injury or anything, no head trauma.
Okay. Alright, now we're gonna call our three lines.
Okay.
So this could be president, crisis team by president, or patients by president, equipment, official equipment, and then patients by type.
Alright, if you're telling Sergeant Farrell those three categories, what is he gonna be?
So patients by presidents, and it seems has to be, I forgot the word, it has to be like urgent, yeah. And then for special equipment, we'll just say resupply and then a litter kit. And then for patients by type, we'll just say it's littered.
At the bird, in a notional way, if the bird is going to be here in 20 minutes or longer, what do you do? If you have to sit on him for 20 minutes plus, what are you doing? Like, if I'm not going to be able to show up, no medics will be there.
Still continue to check on him.
Make sure he's okay, make sure he's breathing.
Make sure his pulses are still good.
Right.
Make sure tourniquet's still applied. He's not getting in shock. He's not into, like, a altered mindset.
Right, so
comforting him.
you've got to wait 20 plus minutes, just start over. Start at March, start at M, massive hemorrhage, do your blood sweep again.
Reassess.
Make sure when you're doing your blood sweep, check the junctionals, check the tourniquets, make sure that's good. That covers that, right? You said that. Check his airway again when you get to airway. You're doing what you just said. Checking his airway, it's still good. Respirations, probably the most important thing to check outside of doing the blood sweep again, is respirations, because one needle D equals a bunch of needle Ds unless they get like a finger thoracostomy or a chest tube or something. So keep checking for those things the whole time. Keep checking his pulses. If you go to check his pulses after 10 minutes and he doesn't have radial pulses, he doesn't have a pulse in his wrist anymore, but he has it as carotid, what does that mean? What does that tell you? He had it at the beginning, and now he only has it up here. He doesn't have it in his wrist.
Stage 2 shock.
He's lost some blood.
A lot of blood.
There's blood gone somewhere, right? Somewhere in here. It's probably pulling up. You can hold all of your blood in your stomach at the mid area.
I know the meaning, but the way he got hurt,
yeah,
he got blown up, and injuries, he's lost his right leg, and he's got an armpit injury on his right arm, and he has a chest wound on the left side of his ribs.
Okay.
And then for signs and symptoms, he wasn't conscious, he was breathing well, and he started losing his pulses on his hand. And then for treatment, we gave him 2 tourniquets. The one on the left, the right arm didn't work, so we applied combat gauze and wrapped it. We got a tourniquet on his right leg, and it's still good. And we got a chest seal on his left ribs.
Okay. Good job. The only thing in the blood sweep, when you have the high insight, just make sure you expose up to that.
Yeah.
Like I said, just to check, because you don't know. That tissue could be torn like all the way up here, right? Could be just not even worth it. I mean, obviously, if it's a tourniquet.